We are always thrilled to have Francine Brokaw, our entertainment correspondent, and especially this month when it's all about heart, and in your case, roses.
Roses. Valentine's Day. And today we're going to be talking about iconic couples on screen.
Oh, perfect.
I know we all have our special people that we go to, but I had a long list, and
How do you narrow it down?
I whittled it down to five, but that was very difficult. I'm going to start with An Affair to Remember.
Okay.
Cary Grant and Deborah Carr.
That, of all the versions, that, except for maybe Sleepless in Seattle, which kind of gave a different slant on the same story, right?
Well, yeah, but An Affair to Remember, this was 1957 okay. with Cary Grant. It was a remake from the 1939 with Irene Dunn and Charles Boyer.
Oh, I don't think I've seen that one.
But then Warren Beatty and Annette Bening redid it in 1994 as Love Story.
Mm-hmm.
Don't waste your time.
Okay.
Stay with Cary Grant.
But isn't that the movie that where they met and they ultimately got married?
I think they met prior,
but
I think they wanted something to do together.
Oh, okay.
And that's how they came about that.
But of those three, the most iconic, certainly.
Cary Grant.
Absolutely.
Yes, yes. I mean, how
anything
can you miss with Cary
Grant?
Exactly. How, you can't miss with him.
What's number two?
Number two, Baby and Johnny from Dirty Dancing.
Dirty Dancing, yeah.
You can't put Baby without Johnny, and Johnny without Baby. And I saw this, besides being on the television, the movies in 1987 when it was first made, and it's been played on mm-hmm. TV a lot, I saw it at the Pantages as a play.
Oh.
And as soon as he said, nobody puts Baby in the corner, the entire theater erupted with applause.
It really has a cult following.
It does. Those two are just, you can't separate them.
And I love Patrick Swayze and anything he did.
Yes, so. he was a nice man.
Yeah,
and
that's what I hear.
I miss him, mm-hmm. I really do. West Side Story, you've got Tony and Maria.
Yeah.
How can you not have one without the other?
Yeah, no.
They are
etched
iconic.
In our hearts.
They are iconic. You have to have Tony and Maria on the iconic couples. They are amazing. Okay, you know me with animated shows.
Always animation somewhere.
You have to have them. I mean, I'm a Disney freak. Everybody knows that. Carl and Ellie from Up.
Okay.
I had to totally put them in the list.
I can totally see that.
That was so special. They are so heartwarming together, and his love for her after she passed, it just lasted the rest mm-hmm. of his life. They're really an iconic love story.
Yep.
And finally, when I whittle this down, I have Lady and the Tramp.
Okay.
I mean, you can't eat a bowl of spaghetti without thinking of Lady and the Tramp.
And doesn't everybody just wish they could share one strand of spaghetti at some time
Isn't
with
that
someone
a romantic,
they truly love?
That is a very romantic scene.
That image is iconic
yes.
of itself.
Now, I had to whittle this down because we don't have enough time for my long list.
Right, but I would need to add Rhett and Scarlett.
They were originally on my list, but he doesn't give a damn, so, so he got taken off.
Frankly,
my dear,
attitude.
I took him off.
All right, you got the wrong attitude, you don't make Francine's list.
No, exactly.
Who else were you
thinking of Love Story.
Yeah.
Ally McGraw
and
Ryan O'Neal.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that they're an iconic couple. But as far as they do have a love story, obviously. I think they had to leave my list because they weren't together that long.
Okay.
You know, but I still would keep them as an iconic couple.
I think what's really cool about your list is that these are icons over decades.
Mm-hmm.
These are couples that everyone does know about.
Yes.
And they have transcended time versus, you know, those that were iconic in the moment because maybe it was a new concept in film.
Yes.
Or something like that hadn't been seen publicly before. So were those some of your criteria?
They were. And also, let's face it, An Affair to Remember is number one on romantic movies for
always.
A lot of lists. I mean, everybody that makes a list will put An Affair to Remember
mm-hmm.
on there. And those characters, they fought through everything to be together.
Yeah.
And to me, that was important.
Well, and I think that storyline has then been recreated, like I mentioned, in Sleepless in Seattle.
Yes.
And you've got Mail, you've got all kinds of, anything with
yes.
Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan.
Well, You've Got Mail is a remake of The Shop Around the Corner.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually had You've Got Mail on my list.
Originally.
But,
yeah.
I know.
Okay.
And you said, whittle it down. And that was so hard.
I bet.
But I think these couples are really, really good. And, I mean, for Valentine's Day, if anybody wants to pick up any of their movies,
yep.
These movies are top notch.
And I think you hit the nail on the head that if you haven't seen the movie,
no.
Or if you're looking to see some new iconic couple, and it's all about heart. We're in the Valentine's month and iconic couples fit. Thank you so much, Francine.
Oh, you're welcome.
Always fun talking movies and entertainment
yes,
with you.
Yes, and happy Valentine's Day.
And to you.
To all the iconic couples out there, enjoy the day.
Absolutely. And who are your iconic couples? Maybe you want to take some time and figure that out and then watch those movies. And we'll be right back.